What's up guys, this is Engineer Jack and this is Reinforced Concrete. So ngayon, pag-usapan natin yung design of beams. So sa design of beams, yung given dito is a factor design moment, axial, or shear. So meron tayong MU, PU, and VU na variables. So nakukuha yan or nakakalculate yan using factored loads. So usually, yung required sa design is lahat. So ito yung talaga yung totoong design. So walang given na dimension, na width, and total depth of the beam. Tayo din magde-decide kung ano yung concrete strength or FC prime and the yield strength na FY for the steel reinforcement. And syempre, tayo din magde-decide kung anong bang diameter of the bar and location yung gagamitin natin dito sa beams natin. But for this subject, syempre, hindi naman talaga unknown lahat. So usually, yung required natin is isa lang or dalawa. Pero usually, isa lang, for example, yung unknown lang is yung reinforcement natin na AS. So for design, usually yung given nga for beams is yung MU or the factored moment na dapat yung factored moment natin is less than or equal to PMN. Or yung PMN is the design strength of the beam. So, meron din tayong given na material strengths na concrete strength and FY na yield strength. So, we have two conditions for equilibrium. Dalawa lang naman yan. So, T and C. So, this the tension force and the compression force. So, yung tension force galing yan sa reinforcement natin. And yung compressive force galing yan sa concrete strength natin. Another equation na babalikan natin dito sa design ay yung nominal moment strength of the beam. So, equal yan sa T times D minus A halves or that is the force times moment arm lang. Or pwede din gamitin natin na C times D minus A halves kasi nga yung T and C are equal lang. And balikan natin yung reinforcement ratio na yung symbol natin is rho and that is equal to AS over BD. So, gagamitin natin yan sa mga susunod na equations natin. And pwede natin ayusin din na yung AS is equal to rho times BD. And this value for AS na rho BD, pwede natin i-substitute yan sa equation for equation 1 na T equals to C. So yung T equals to C natin, this ASFY, yung T, paki-imagine na lang guys, no? And yung C natin, that is 0.85 FC prime times AB. So kung papalitan natin yung AS na equal to rho BD, magkakaroon tayo now na rho BD FY is equal to 0.85 FC prime AB. So, yung value natin for A, or the depth of the compressive block now, pag in-simplify natin, that is also equal to rho times closing parenthesis FY all over 0.85 FC prime closing parenthesis times D or the effective depth. So, let's say this is equation 3. So ngayon, itong equation 3 is substitute naman natin sa equation 2 or for the formula for the nominal moment strength. So, for MN now, so gagamitin natin is T times D minus A halves. So, yung T natin, that is ASFY. Or, gagamitin natin for AS, rho BD times FY. Tapos, closing parenthesis, defective depth minus 1 half of A. So, meron tayong value for A na itong equation 3. So, D minus rho over 2, closing parenthesis, FY all over 0.85 FC prime times D, closing parenthesis. So, meron tayong common na effective depth. So, pwede natin yan i-factor out. So, pag nilabas natin yung D, magkakaroon tayo now na rho BD squared FY, closing parenthesis, 1 minus rho over 2 times, closing parenthesis, FY all over 0.85 FC prime, closing parenthesis. So, let's say this is equation 4. Ngayon, meron tayong tinatawag na Rn. Itong Rn, ito yung tinatawag na coefficient of resistance. And it is obtained by dividing the last equation or that equation 4 by BD squared and letting M is equal to FY all over 0.85 FC prime. So, yung purpose lang ng letter M para mapaikli natin yung formula. So, ito yung equation 4 natin. So, pag nag-divide tayo ng BD square, so magkakaroon tayo ng Rn value. Kasi pag nag-divide tayo ng BD square nga, sa nominal moment strength, this is the coefficient of resistance Rn. And this is also equal to, syempre magkakancel yung BD squared, so rho Fy na lang, closing parenthesis, 1 minus rho over 2, closing parenthesis naman, Fy all over 0.85 FC prime. So, itong Fy over 0.85 FC prime, para mas maikli yung formula natin tingnan, pwede natin yan palitan na variable M. So, we have new equation now for resistance Rn, or coefficient of resistance, is equal to rho Fy, closing parenthesis, 1 minus rho M all over 2. Ngayon, pwede natin guys i-distribute yung rho Fy sa loob ng equation. So, pag i-distribute natin itong rho Fy sa loob, so magkakaroon tayo ng Rn is equal to rho Fy minus nfy rho squared all over 2. Kasi meron tayong rho sa loob, so magiging square. So, multiply tayo ng 2 both sides para mawala yung denominator na 2. So, magkakaroon tayo ng 2rn is equal to 2 rho fy minus mfy rho squared. So, let's say yung rho natin, this variable x, and yung fy, m, and rn, that is all constant. So, pwede tayo guys mag-completing the square. But before that, mag-multiply tayo ng negative 1. So, mangyayari, magiging negative 2rn is equal to negative 2 rho fy. Ito magiging positive kasi mag-multiply tayo ng negative 1. So, plus mfy rho squared. Sabi ko nga, yung rho natin, paki-imagine na lang, na that is variable x. So, meron tayong quadratic equation. So, ang gagawin natin, yung constant for our rho squared, tanggalin natin yan. So, mag-divide ako both sides ng m times fy. So, magkakaroon tayo now na equation na negative 2rn all over m fy is equal to rho squared minus 2 rho over m. So, for completing the square, yung rho squared natin minus 2p over m, pwede tayong mag-add ng constant para maging complete square siya. So, magagawin natin, so itong negative 2 over m, divide 2 tapos square, so mag-add tayo ng 1 over m squared. So, para maging complete yung square natin. So, pag nag-add tayo dito sa kabila, mag-add din tayo sa kabila. Mag-add din tayo dito ng 1 over m squared. 1 over m squared nga, kasi itong constant for rho, mag-divide tayo ng 2 tapos square. So, yan yung rule natin for completing the square. So, negative 2 over m all over 2, magiging negative 1 over m squared, kaya magiging 1 over m squared. So, paki-imagine na lang guys. Then, simplify natin. So, ito, magiging 1 over m squared minus 2rn all over m fy is equal to, ito, pwede natin guys yan i-simplify na closing parenthesis rho minus 1 over m squared. Tapos, pag expand natin yan, dapat babalik lang. Then, ito guys sa left equation, pwede natin yan i-simplify. Pwede natin ilabas yung 1 over m squared. So, pag nilabas natin, magkakaroon tayo now ng 1 over m squared, closing parenthesis, 1 minus 2rn m all over fy, closing parenthesis. So, taking square root naman. So, if we take square root both sides, so magkakaroon tayo sa kabila ng positive or negative 1 over m square root of 1 minus 2rn m all over fy. And sa kabila naman, meron tayong rho minus 1 over m. So, yung 1 over m, ilipat naman natin sa kabila. So, magkakaroon tayo ng 1 over m plus or minus 1 over m square root of this value. Then, pwede din ulit natin i-factor out yung 1 over m. So, yung formula natin now for rho, that is 1 over m, closing parenthesis, 1 plus or minus square root of 1 minus 2rn times m all over fy. Pero guys, yung ginagamit lang talaga natin is yung minus lang na sign. Kasi nga, iniiwasan natin yung balance condition or the compression controlled condition. So, pinapalit lang natin yung value for rho. Kasi itong rho, this is the steel reinforcement ratio. So, para hindi natin maabot yung compression control, konti lang dapat yung value natin for rho or the steel reinforcement ratio para makuha din natin maliit lang na reinforcement. Kasi nga, pag yung ginamit natin is yung plus, pwede natin maabot yung compression control. Eh, yun nga yung iniingatan natin or iniiwasan natin sa design of beams. Kaya yung ginagamit natin is negative lang. So, this another formula na kailangan natin isaulo dito sa design. Ngayon, pag-usapan natin yung design procedure for single reinforced concrete rectangular sections for flexure. So, usually, yung required lang dito is yung reinforcement natin or AS. So, first step, isiset natin yung MU kasi yung given lang nga dito is yung MU. Ini-equate natin yan sa VMN or the design strength of the beam natin. So, nangyayari lang yan pag-design kasi nga yung given is yung MU. Pero yung meaning ng MU and VMN, magkaiba yan kasi nga yung MU, nakukuha yan due to factored loads. And yung VMN naman, magkaiba naman yung pag-solve niyan. So, nagkataon lang na ini-equate natin yan for design procedure. So, for this equation na m equals to Vmn, pwede din natin sabihin na yung mn is equal to mu over v. So, next step naman, find the flexural resistance Rn. So, para makuha natin yan, ay di-divide lang natin yung nominal moment strength or mn by bd square. So, for this mm, meron tayong mu nga over phi. So, ito yung given. So, pwede na din natin sabihin na yung rn, that is also equal to mu all over phi bd square. Kasi nga yung mn, that is mu over phi. Sinubstitute lang natin dito. So, equal lang naman yan. Next step for our design, we should determine the steel reinforcement ratio rho. So, meron tayong na-derive kanina na formula. Yung rho natin, that is also equal to 1 over m, closing parenthesis 1 minus square root of 1 minus 2rnm over fy. Na yung m nga natin, equal lang yan sa fy over 0.85 fc prime. So, yung lahat yan na formula dapat guys as a whole natin kasi hindi yan given sa mga exams. Tapos yung rn nga natin dito, equal nga yan sa mu over phi bd square. So, itong dalawa na m and rn, just substitute dito sa value para makuha natin yung value for the steel reinforcement. And for step number 4, after natin makuha yung steel reinforcement ratio rho, check for maximum and minimum steel reinforcement ratio. Kasi nga, yung rho natin for design of singly reinforced concrete rectangular beams, dapat yung rho natin is less than rho max and dapat greater than din sa rho min. So, meron tayong value for rho max, equal nga yan sa 0.75 rho balance, where rho balance is equal to 0.85 fc prime, beta 1 all over fy, closing parenthesis 600 all over 600 plus fy. And for minimum reinforcement naman, yung gagamitin natin kung alin dito sa dalawa, yung mas malaking value. And itong dalawang formula galing to sa NCP. So sa NCP, meron tayong AS mean. So yung ginawa ko, nag-divide ako ng BD, kaya nagkaroon tayo ng mas maikling formula for rho mean. So yung given niya sa NCP is AS mean. So yung ginawa ko, naging rho mean nila. So kung alin dito mas malaki, yun gagamitin natin for rho minimum. And yun yung compare natin sa nakuha natin na value for step number 3 na steel reinforcement ratio rho. Number 5, after natin guys ma-check kung okay na yung rho natin is less than rho max and if it's greater than the rho min, if it satisfies that equation, so diretso na tayo sa step number 5. Solve natin yung AS required. So para makuha natin yung AS required, gagamitin lang natin yung steel reinforcement ratio na AS over BD. And yung rho natin nakuha for step number 3, imumultiply lang natin yan sa BD para makuha natin yung AS required. So yung BD is the width of the beam and yung BD is the effective depth of the beam. So step number 6 naman, after natin makuha yung AS required, determine the number of bars to be used. So para makuha yan, so yung variable N, let's say this is the number of bars na gagamitin natin. And that is also equal to AS required na nakuha natin dito sa step number 5 all over pi over 4 dB squared. So yung dB squared, ito yung gagamitin natin na diameter for our bars. Ngayon, if AS provided is greater than or equal to 1.33 AS required, no need to use AS mean na ginamit natin sa step number 4. Kasi nga, yung AS required, ito yung nakuha natin for rho na nakuha natin for step number 3. So, just multiplied by BD. So, yung makuha natin na value doon is AS required. Ngayon, yung AS provided natin, ito talaga yung ginamit natin na number of bars. For example, nakuha natin na AS required, naka-square millimeters. Tapos, pag nag-divide tayo ng pi over 4 diameter bar squared, so meron tayong ginamit na diameter. Let's say, makuha natin for number of bars is 4.2. So, wala naman talaga tayong 0.2 na bar, so gagamitin natin 5 bars. So yung 5 bars, pag kinupit natin yung area niyan, that is AS provided. Na pag chinek nga natin itong equation na greater than siya sa 1.33 AS required, just neglect na formula for AS mean. Yan yung ibig sabihin for step number 6. So next step for number 7, check for steel bar arrangement in section. So dito natin malalaman if there are 2 or more layers of our steel reinforcement. Kasi may chinecheck tayo na spacing of our steel reinforcement. So meron tayong minimum spacing lang, hindi dapat doon lilit. And yung number 8 naman, step number 8, after natin ma-check yung arrangement of the section, then saka tayo mag-analysis ulit. So, i-check natin yung VMN na dapat greater than yan sa MU pa din. Isosolve tayo guys ng example problem sa design of singly reinforced concrete rectangular sections for flexure. So, basahin ko muna yung problem. Calculate the area of steel reinforcement required for the beam. So, meron tayong given na MU that is equal to 360 kN. take Fc prime equal to 30 megapascal, Fy equals to 400 megapascal, and use 25 millimeters steel bar as one layer arrangement. So meron tayong given dimensions, meron tayong width na 300 millimeters, and total depth na 650 millimeters. So first solution, iniset natin yung mu na given is equal to phi mn, where mn nga, that is also equal to mu over phi. So, wala tayo guys given na phi. So, mag-assume tayo na yung phi natin is equal to 0.9 for flexure. Kasi nga, dapat yung design natin for beams is dapat naka-tension control. So, yung phi for tension control, that is 0.90. Solve for mn, or the nominal moment strength of the beam, so equal to mu over phi is equal to 360 kN meter all over 0.9. So, that is also equal to 400 kilonewton meter. Ito yung nominal moment strength of the beam. So, second step, we will solve the Rn value or the coefficient of resistance. So, yung Rn natin, mag-divide lang tayo for Mn na BD square. But before that, wala tayo guys value for effective depth. So, para makuha natin yung effective depth, tatanda lang natin itong formula. Na yung effective depth, that is also equal to the total depth of the beam minus concrete cover minus the diameter of the stirrups minus kalahati ng diameter of the bar. Kasi nga, yung effective depth natin, nag-i-start yan from the top compression face hanggang dun sa centroid of our reinforcement. Kaya, kalahati ng diameter of the bar. So, meron tayong total depth of the beam na 650 millimeters. So, yung concrete cover, pag walang given, always use 40 millimeters. Kasi ito yung given sa NCP natin for beams. And wala ding sinabi na diameter of the stirrup. So, use 10 din pag walang sinabi. Kasi usually, yung diameter of stirrups is 10 millimeters. And yung ginamit nga natin diameter of the bar, sinabi sa problem na 25 millimeters. So, 25 over 2. So, pag tinalculate natin yan, yung effective depth now is 587.5 millimeters. So, pwede nyo guys i-check yung pagkakalculate ko kung tama yan. Then, after natin makuha yung effective depth, pwede natin guys makuha yung value for Rn or the coefficient of resistance. So, yung Rn, that is also equal to yung Mn, that is 400 kilonewton meter. All over, yung width natin is 300 millimeters or 0.3 meters times yung effective depth na 587, syempre gagawin din natin na meter, so 0.5875 meters and dapat naka-square. And that is also equal to, yung value now for Rn is 3.862.984759 kilonewton per square meter, or that is kilopascal. Para maging megapascal, mag-divide pa tayo ng 1,000, kaya yung Rn now is 3.862984759 megapascal. After natin guys mag-solve yung Rn, yung next step natin, i-solve natin yung steel reinforcement ratio. So, meron tayong na-derive kanina na formula for rho na is equal to 1 over m, closing parenthesis 1 minus square root of 1 minus 2rnm all over Fy. Na meron tayong value for m, that is also equal to Fy over 0.85 Fc prime. Na pwede natin yan i-solve or i-calculate. So, yung m, meron tayong Fy ng 400 megapascal. Tinanggal ko na guys yung unit kasi meron tayong Fc prime na yung unit nga is megapascal din. So, magka-cancel lang naman. So, yung value natin for m, that is 15.6862754.51. So, pwede nyo guys i-pause yung video and i-check yung pagka-calculate ko. So, substitute the value for m and rn sa equation. So, yung rho is equal to 1 over 15.6862754.51, closing parenthesis, 1 minus square root of 1 minus 2 times yung rn na 3.862984759 times yung m na 15.6862754.51 all over 400 megapascal. So, yung itong numerator, pwede natin i-simplify yan. That is 1 to 1.1916787. Pwede nyo guys balikan yung kanina yung slide na dapat tama yung value natin na 1 to 1. Then 1 to 1 over 400, that is 0.302979191968. So 1 minus that value, so meron tayong square root of 0.67020832. So hindi ako guys nag-round off for accuracy. Then square root nyan, that is also equal to 0.83487771.75. So, 1 minus that value, that is 0.165122225, and divide by 15.6862745. So meron tayong valid enough for a stereo reinforcement ratio na 0.01052654551. So ito na yung value for RO. After natin guys masolve yung RO, i-check natin yan sa RO max and RO min. So itong equation dapat masatisfy natin. So yung RO max natin, meron tayong formula na 0.75 RO balance, na yung RO balance nga natin na equal yan sa 0.85 FC prime beta 1 all over FY times 600 all over 600 plus FY. So wala tayo guys value for beta 1, pero meron tayong value for FC prime and FY. Para makuha natin yung beta, as you can see, meron tayong 13 megapascal na given. So kung NSCP 2015 yung gagamitin natin, meron tayong value for beta 1 na if FC prime is greater than 28 megapascal, ito yung formula gagamitin natin. So 0.85 minus 0.05 over 7 times FC prime minus 28. So meron tayong 30 megapascal. So just substitute the value. So beta 1 is equal to 0.85 minus 0.05 over 7 times 30 minus 28. So, hindi ko na guys simplify. So, yung beta 1 is 0.83571428572857. So, just substitute the value for raw balance. So, meron tayong FC prime na 30 megapascal, FY na 400, and meron tayong beta 1. So, yung raw balance now natin is 0.85 times 30 megapascal times 0.83571428572857 all over 400. Closing parenthesis, 600 all over 600 plus 400. So, simplify natin yan. So, itong 600 over 1,000, kasi 600 plus 400, that is 1,000. And 600 over 1,000, that is 0.6. So, itong numerator, pwede natin i-simplify yan. That is 12.78642857. So, pwede nyo guys i-pause yung video and i-check yung pagkakalculate ko kung tama ba. Then, itong numerator or all over 400, that is 0.31966607143. Then, after natin masolve yung raw balance, multiply 0.75 para makuha natin yung raw max. So, yung raw max now is 0.02397455357. So, pag chinect natin sa raw, greater than yung raw max pa din, and this is okay. So, syempre, i-check din natin yung raw natin, dapat greater than sa raw min. So, meron tayong dalawang equation for raw min. So, kung alin dito yung mas malaki, doon natin i-compare yung raw natin. So, meron tayong formula na raw min na 0.25 FC prime all over FY. And another formula na 1.4 all over FY. So, substitute the value for FC prime and FY. So, 0.85 is square root of 30 all over 400. That is 0.00342326.5984. And for the another formula na 1.4 over FY, 1.4 over 400, that is 0.0035. So, yung mas malaki sa dalawa, itong 0.0035. And dito natin i-compare yung raw. So, kitang-kita natin na that is greater than. So, yung 0.01, that is greater than sa raw min. Ibig sabihin, itong equation na satisfy natin na yung raw natin less than sa raw max and greater than sa raw min. After natin ma-check na yung raw okay na siya, kukunin natin guys yung AS required. So, yung AS required, just multiply the value for raw times BD. So, yung raw natin is 0.01052654551 times width na 300 mm and effective depth na 587.5 mm. So, yung AS now is 1855.303646 square mm. And itong AS nga, ito yung tinatawag na AS required. So, after natin makuha yung AS required, next step, we will determine the number of bars. So, meron tayong ginamit na 25 mm. So, para makuha natin yung number of bars, equal lang yan sa AS required all over pi over 4 dB squared. Just substitute. So, 1855.303646 square mm all over pi over 4, 25 mm squared. So, that is 3.77959355252 bars. So, let's say that is 425 millimeter bars. So, ang gagamitin natin is apat na bars. Yung apat na bars, yan yung tinatawag na AS provided natin. So ngayon, after natin ma-check yung number of bars, saka tayo mag-a-analysis. So i-check natin yung 4 na apat na 25 mm bars. Check muna natin yung spacing of our reinforcement. So meron tayong apat na 25 mm, i-check natin kung one layer arrangement lang siya. So para ma-check natin yan, yung width na 300 mm, ililess natin yung dalawang concrete cover both sides, kaya minus 2 times 40, and meron din tayong dalawang stirrups, kaya minus 2 times 10, and ililess din natin yung diameter na apat na 25 mm, kaya minus 4 times 25, and if meron tayong apat na bars, ibig sabihin yung spacing between them, meron tayong tatlo, kaya all over 3. Pag kinalculate natin yan, yung spacing now is 33.330 mm. So that is greater than 25 mm kasi nga yung limit natin is 25 mm, so okay siya. Ibig sabihin, itong apat na bars, one layer arrangement lang siya. So okay to. Then after we check our spacing, i-check natin yung effective depth natin na D. So same lang naman yan kasi one layer arrangement lang tayo. So yung effective depth natin ulit is 587.5 mm. Then saka tayo mag-a-analysis guys. Kaya i-check din natin yung VMN na greater than sa MU. So yung purpose nito is para ma-master natin yung design and analysis. So for analysis, meron tayong formula na MN na C or T times D minus A halves. Na meron tayong formula for A or D is the depth of the compression block is equal to ASFY all over 0.85 FC prime times B. So ang gagamitin natin ng value for AS is yung AS provided natin na apat na 25 mm bars. So yung AS is 4 times pi over 4 D squared or pi over 4 times 25 squared times FY na 400 newton per square millimeters. Yung newton per square millimeters, that is megapascal din. All over 0.85 times 30 times 300. So yung A natin now is 102.666 4266 mm. So pwede rin guys i-pause yung video and i-check yung pagkakalculate ko. Then after natin makasolve yung A, we can now solve the value of the nominal moment strength na MN. That is ASFY times D minus A halves. So substitute. So meron tayong AS na apat na 25 mm. Kaya 4 times pi over 4 times 25 squared times FY na 400. Effective depth na 587.5. And yung A na 102.666 4266 mm. And that value for MN is 421,104,409.6 Nm. So divide by 1 million. So meron tayong value for MN now na 421,104,409.6 kN/m. Pero guys, hindi pa to guys yung design strength kasi nga kailangan natin yung value for phi. So check muna natin yung net tensile strain or strain S. So meron tayong formula for net tensile strain na 0.003 closing parenthesis D minus C all over C. So wala tayong value for C pero meron tayong value for D. And para makuha natin yung value for C, equal yan sa A over beta 1. Na yung beta 1 nga natin, i-compute din natin yan, na equal nga yan sa 0.83571428.57. So yung A natin 102.666 4266 mm all over beta, and the value of C is 122.848715.6 mm. Paka-check na lang guys kung tama yung pagka-calculate ko. Then substitute the value for C dito sa equation para makuha natin yung net tensile strain. So substitute the value for D and C, and the value now for strain S is equal to 0.011346 91435, and that is greater than 0.005. Ibig sabihin, yung gagamitin natin for phi, that is 0.9. Kasi nga, pag greater than sa 0.005, yung strain S natin or the net tensile strain, ibig sabihin na sa tension controlled tayo. So yung gagamitin natin is 0.9 for phi. Just multiply the value for MN, so meron tayong value for VMN na 378.9939686 kN/m. And that is greater than MU kasi yung given na MU is 360 lang. So ibig sabihin, okay yung design natin. And that's it. Thank you very much and have a good day.